Hello and welcome to my show. Hope you have a fun time, you know. So welcome to my show. Hello, everybody. This is Holly Lindin, aka Seed Green Dandelion Bean. Welcome to the 8th episode of my 100 Baby Challenge with the beautiful, bountiful, fabulous Bloom family. Sound like I said balloon. I've made some changes since the last episode. And oh boy, was the last episode a doozy. It was the longest to date, wasn't it? Either 7 or 5 was the longest, but they were both up there. I didn't intend that for episode 7 in any way, shape, or form. Because with all the crashes and all the bullshit that I had to go through, I really thought it was going to be like a half an hour. And then I'm editing through the thing this morning and I'm like, well, shit, this is really fucking long. So if you stuck around for almost 2 hours to watch that fabulousness, then, or Drek, however you see it. But if you're watching Drek, I mean, come on, you're wasting your time. Thanks. Thanks a lot for watching it. So I've made some changes to the house. Now that I've decided that, you know, the kids need more room and Willow and Ian and their upcoming baby/babies need more room and so on and so forth, I've actually built something a little different. And now for something completely different. I've actually built something. We've built onto the house. We have built a second house onto the house that is connected to the main house. And I think that's maybe something I'm going to be doing when people start having their own families or whatever. I'm going to bunch them together in separate little houses that are all connected to the main house. This way, we don't lose track of them and we don't, we get to still see them, but they don't need to be a focus unless I really want them to be. So this is the house. Obviously, we had only one level. Just a few minutes ago, we only had one level. And now we've got, come on, work with me, camera. Come on. And now we have something that's quite different. So let's go through it really quick. I won't do a tour, but, oh, I didn't paint upstairs. Oh, that's fine. I'll have to do that. So let's see what we got here. I've kept a lot of this main house the same, as you can see. Aloe's room's a little bigger. I made this, you know, a little more square with each other. I moved the bookshelf. I got rid of the kids' room, obviously, and put in a spiral staircase. This room's up for grabs to a certain extent. I think at some point I'm going to put like a chess table and 2 chairs. I elongated the bathroom so that it carries all the way to the fence here, so you actually can't go around the house anymore, which makes me happy because there was too much of, oh, I'm standing right here outside and I need to go to this bathroom. Okay. Like, you're retarded, Sims. Come on. You could have just gone right in this door. I recognize the house was glitchy and people were acting all frickety fucky because the house was so glitchy, thanks to our sweet beautiful little Snow, who thankfully is, yes, still with us. So because I'm gonna do everything in my power to make sure she sticks with us, I put in another shower and 3 more stalls, so that will really make things a little bit easier for the house. When you go up the spiral staircase, this is what we find. So we have a couple bedrooms that will be for couples or whatever. Yeah. So here we're going to have Rowan and hopefully Jake. Jake will hopefully move in. This will be Cedar and Carlotta's room. And what's great about these rooms is they're nice and big. So if I want to, I can put in a TV or a computer or a desk, or I can put a little, a baby crib or whatever, as opposed to a teenage crib, whatever. And this is just a little sitting area. I've made it just really, really simple. But I think I'm going to throw a desk and a computer in here at some point. Yes, I mother-loaded the shit out of this, just for the record. And that's fine. And here's a little bedroom, you know. And if I need to, I can put another bunk bed here or another bunk bed here, depending how many triplets and quadruplets Aloe has next. And then upstairs, I just have a few rooms ready, 3 rooms here, and maybe a little sitting/games room for when other kids age up and they start having urges. No. And they start having a couple, like being in a relationship or whatever, and wanting people to move in. And this is the little bathroom on the second floor. So I've simplified the house a little bit. And we needed that desperately. I've put in this little half wall here. I really enjoy that. It's not so closed off. And I may actually move these things in here and put a little table in here so people can get together and hang out and stuff instead of going outside to eat their food, because that doesn't make any sense. So if you follow the house all the way around to the back, you've got this little alleyway where people can make snowmen and dick around. We've got this little road here that leads to Willow, Ian, and their future baby / baby's front door. And I'm actually going to, well, now that they're in there, I think they're the only ones in there, I'm going to lock it to everyone. Let's see here. Let's specify Sims for this door. Sims who can open this door. Literally just Willow at this point until Ian moves in, and then Ian can mess around with that. But Rowan is in here, so we're going to teleport him out. That'll be the first thing we do. Whoopsie. How did I miss the whole word? That was weird. Testing cheats enabled. True. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so let's make all happy, because that's what I do at the beginning of every episode. But I think I already did that before I saved, didn't I? Yeah, everyone seems pretty happy, don't they? And oh, she's gonna puke. Oh, she's gonna puke. This doesn't matter, but let's see. Rowan is in the house, isn't he? Rowan's in the house. So let's teleport him there. So the only people who are going to be allowed into this house are Willow and Ian and whatever child that they have. So now Ian and Willow and or Willow can't leave the house for whatever. I just don't want them so much to be intermingling, because I wanted to give that illusion that, hey, they live separately. But, you know, like we would have had if Willow was able to actually move out, if the game would let me kick people out, but it won't right now. So this is Willow's house. Obviously, it has a bit of a different feel. You know, you go over to this house and it's Lilac City, and then you come over here and it's all honey and brown and yellow. I love that. And each house is going to reflect that. Absolutely. But I think I'm only going to build houses for people who are having children, and I may just throw some people together. There may be some point where Rowan has had too many kids, because he needs to have five children, you know, for Surrounded by Family, raise five children from babies to teenagers. He needs to do that. So I may have him move over here and have his own level to the house or whatever. And then each one of these, you know, we can have a triplet house or something. So Rowan, Cedar, and Willow can live in this house, and then I'll build another house for the triplet daughters, and then build another house for a bunch of the other kids. But that comes in the future, possibly. So this is Willow's cute little house. I really like it. The first 15 minutes of this, of episode 8, is just going to be me saying, here's a house, look at it. So you come in, the front door is here. Whoop, whoop. There's a little desk here. It's really simplistic, this house. I mean, they have basically the bare, not even, well, more than the bare minimums, because TV and a, like, basically PlayStation are not necessary. But we've got this nice big table for an upcoming child, and I might copy that table and put it over here and then just paint it purple. There's a little bathroom, a kid's room there, Willow and Ian's room, and then upstairs we don't have anything at this point. So it's very, very exciting. There's nothing. It's so exciting. So let me go through. I'm going to go through their portraits and see what they're most interested in today. She wants to hire an executive butler. Yeah, I'm not interested in that. Not in the slightest. We are going to get rid of this stupid fucking... and everyone just graduated, which is pretty exciting. Throw a gift-giving party. So we just throw a party, and then people show up, I guess, and bring gifts, is what I'm understanding. Okay, Willow, you're going to have to throw up soon. What's happening here? Oh, he's valedictorian, so what does he get? Only a few can ever say that they are the best. I am the best. I can say that. And Rowan, how is he hunted? Who is hunting him? I'm going to get rid of that, because that is stupid. a lot of them want a gift-giving party. So we are going to do that at Aloe's house. And before we do that, I'm going to specify Sims for Aloe's house. Let me see. I wish there was a way that I could lock Willow's door so that only she and Ian could get in, but anybody can get out. Because once I lock it, she can't get out. So if I want her to come over to the house for this party, she can't get out. I think that's really stupid, and I wish there was another way that I could do that. But I have no idea, because I am an idiot. So, what was I just going to do? We are going to throw this party. We are going to throw a freaking awesome party. And Aloe, let's recap. Aloe is pregnant with Emmett Preston. Hot, hot, sexy little Emmett Preston. He's a hottie. And do you think he's hot? Yeah, that's what I think. So she's pregnant with his hopefully many babies, hopefully like 17 children. Could you imagine? That would just break the game. My daughter's meowing at me. Pay attention to me. I already told her. And I already told her. I'm recording an episode today, so you guys gotta be quiet, please. Because we have two little feline daughters. I noticed it was either 6 or 7 when I was editing episode 6 or 7. I noticed what someone was painting here. Mushrooms and the Mario hat and a little pipe to go down. I thought that was pretty funny. And I was like, how did I miss that when I was actually recording? That's funny. So I just wanted to point it out to anyone who missed it yourselves, you know. So this is cool because we can see what's going on in Willow's house too. Let's just turn it on. Let's just go for it. Isn't it weird? Winter, 3 days till spring. All right. Winter seems forever. How does winter seem forever? It is really, really wild. Your intent here, what I'd like for you, Aloe. You have to open this slowly, otherwise it doesn't open. It's really lame. What I intend for you is to throw a party. We're going to throw a gift-giving party because it is, what, everybody? Snowflake Day! Throw a gift-giving party. And then we're going to go over to Willow. So we're basically... Oh, she's going to... What is she watching? She was watching something. Oh, cooking? Tyler is still a child? Huh. Weird. We'll invite Tyler. Bruce Chesterfield, because we haven't yet had a baby. So let's talk it up with him. Gift-giving party. What's it? Sunday? Okay, let's do it at 11 in the morning. Select code casual. Okay. Benjamin Larson. Who did I... Oh, I wanted Willow to be with Benjamin Larson. Well, that's not going to happen now. Here's a new one. Madeline Moore. Ooh. Ian Nally. No, I'm not gonna ask him to come because he's coming anyway. So, I mean, no, he isn't. He's with Willow. So they're not coming to the party, maybe. I don't know. Life is hard, man. Let's invite Jake, and then we can hopefully get Rowan to get him to move in. Nicholas Riverhawk. Come on, Candace. Come over. Ruben Paulette, and I think I'm going to change his name to Paul Ruben. Carlotta. Okay, so that's the... So I got a couple people for Aloe to get to know, and we got Paul for Snow. We're just going to start calling him Paul now because I'm going to change it like as soon as possible. We got Carlotta coming for Cedar, and we got Jake coming for Rowan. So let's invite all of those slapdap happy people. There it is again. Is this Bruce Chesterfield going after Rowan again? That's there's something cute about that, but there's also something a little predatory. To catch a predatory. Yes, I know you have to pee or throw up, I mean. But you can only do it here. What? She's not leaving. How'd she get out? But I locked it. Huh. For some reason, she could Get out of the house. Peach, don't strangle yourself. That's so disturbing. So disturbing. Oh my God. Whoever's phone that is, I'm gonna lose my shit on ya. That didn't sound right. German Scheiße film. Oh, yes! When you specify Sims for a door, it means that only those Sims can go in and go out of said door. So yes, there is a thing for that. Oh my God. There's an app for that. Let's go do some stuff here. Let's get romanticized with our Mr. Ian. Your gift-giving party's gonna start soon. If you have the room, we'll send a pile of gifts to get you started. Don't worry, your guests will be bringing their own gifts. Now, how do you send me a pile of gifts to get started? That's the question I would like to know. Take a romantic photo together, and then let's propose marriage, because I want him to move in, like, stat. And hopefully he will. Gifts! Gifts, gifts, gifts! Gifts, gifts, gifts! And, like I mentioned before, I'm gonna move some shit over. Gonna move the shit over, yeah, yeah. Okay, the move objects. If I seem a little slow this morning, it's because it is morning. It's like 10:30 in the morning. I'm really tired. I didn't sleep very well last night. I was just really, really anxious. And then I woke up feeling a little shaky and stuff like that. And no, I don't drink coffee or anything else like that. So I don't know. It's just one of those nights. I stayed up the latest, like until 4:30. That's the latest I've stayed up in a really long time, because I used to take sleep for granted, and then I got really, really sick for, like, I'm still getting over it, candida related. I'm going to release a video about that at some point, because it's really important for people to get the information, the real information about candida, because it's killing all of us, really. But that made me incredibly sick for almost a year. In December it'll be a year, and but it'll be, you know, it's candida's completely gone, but whatever. Long story short, I was really, really sick. I was bedridden and bathridden, and I could not do anything. I couldn't even sleep, so I would go for days and days and days without eating and sleeping and stuff. I lost over 130 pounds in 9 months because I changed my life completely. It was wonderful. Worst experience ever, but best experience ever. But the point is that I took sleep for granted for so long, and then I couldn't sleep. And then I was just like, oh my God. So now I don't take sleep for granted. So it was really weird last night that I stayed up so late, because it's just not like me. That will not become a habit. Absolutely not. Who is this? What? Who else is confused as shit? So now Paulette Rubin is actually Paulette Rubin and not... wait. So Paulette Rubin is a girl. Let's sleuth this. Because I am so confused. You have no idea. Let's sleuth the shit out of this. Paulette Rubin is a girl. So when Paulette Rubin was young, she had boy hair, and that confused me. Well, I still want her to be with Snow. That's what I've decided. I would still like her to be with Snow. So I definitely am going to get Snow and Paulette to be friends. Invite everyone in. The first guest has arrived. Aw, yeah. Aw, yeah. Oh my God. Canceled the wrong thing. What is this? Build a snowman. Ah! Your sim wants to build a holly jolly snowman. I am quite jolly. Just remember that if it actually came to life and danced around the town square, that would probably be terrifying for everybody. Yes, do we not think about this when we watch these Christmas specials and shit of things coming to life that shouldn't be coming to life? That is creepy. Greetings, Willow. We're throwing a feast party for the neighborhood, and I'm hoping you can come. Bring a guest if you like, but more importantly, a big reporter. Okay. Willow, are you gonna, not Willow. No. Absolutely no. Snow and Paulette, you two need to get on. Oh, well, look at this. More gifts are actually being added. Let's see. Let's watch. She sets it down. Set it down, Paulette. Set it down. Oh, she brought food. Never mind. Where'd she go? Am I blind? Oh, she's at the counter. Oh, it didn't actually add anything. I was thinking when they put their gifts down, it would actually add something. Go talk to her. Come on, please. Oh, no. Oh, thank the universe. What just happened? I told you to take that wish. That was weird. Is that... No, that's not Candace. There's Candace. This woman here. Layla Al-Fahad. What is going on? Some weird shit's happening here, people. Weird shit. You just got here. No. No, no, no. No, 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 no. Don't even... You know what I'm going to do? You know what I'm gonna do. Lock. Everyone but myself. Lock. Everyone but myself. Dang nabbit. You aren't going anywhere, Candace. Lock everyone but myself. Just until the party's over and until everybody really wants to leave. And there is the possibility she could teleport out just on her own. Clementine. Oh, good, they're talking. They're talking. He should have aged up by now. I almost want to age him up. Yeah, get to know him. Become best friends. I know he's younger, but... Hey, my partner's younger than me. Well, not by much. By 1 month and 2 days. But still. Still. Age ain't nothing but a number. I mean, at this point, he's a little young. But... Let's become best friends, and then when he ages up, we will be all ready. We will be ready for him. Get to know. I'm just trying to get people's relationships up a little bit. And Aloe. Yeah, you're going to find out right about now, Missy, that... Oh my god! I told you, she may just teleport out of here. For frick's sake. Okay, Aloe, come talk to someone new then. Nicholas Riverhawk, he is a cutie pie, so let's talk to him. Actually, I want you to talk to a woman. I would like you to be with a woman next. How about Layla Al-Fahad? Friendly introduction. Go meet Layla. Layla, ba-dum-bum. You got me on my... Whatever. I don't know that song completely well. And then at the same time, what we need to do is, well, there's Carlotta taking off to do her homework because she's just such a party animal. No, no, no. Come on, Cedar. Come talk to Carlotta. We want to try to get her to move in. She's still a teen, though. But that's okay. That's okay. I think I can get her to move in even if she's a teen. That's really fine. Watch gifts being opened. This is so new to me. This is really funny. Snow, talk to Paulette. So we're obviously not going to be changing Paulette's name. Because Paulette is a girl. I would like Paulette and Snow to be together. So are people going to actually exchange gifts? Or what is going on? Oh, there are more gifts here. Is there? Are there? Is there? Are there? Something? Whatever. I'm going to put most of this shit. Oh, he opened a gift. What did you get, Sky? What'd you get? I hope it tells you. He received a busy bee bouncing bauble. Cool. The family inventory. It should be in their inventory. That doesn't mean... any sense. Try tip tofu steak. Try saying that 5 times fast. Hamburglar. Put it in there. Clementine. Oh, yeah. Yeah, get back to this. Come on. You guys got to talk to each other. Are they just going to come one at a time and pick a gift and it's going to be just some shitty little $2 thing you can... All right. What did Wolf get? Tell me, game. Wolf Bloom received a Maxoid Game Simulator 2.5. Holy shit. So Sky got this shitty little, like, 2 simoleon shit. Okay, it looks like even with the doors locked, people are just leaving. Oh, Paulette is interested in Cherry. Maybe that's what I should do then. Maybe that's what I should do. Kind of let fate do its thing. The game's letting me know. Peach got that too. Crazy. Don't worry about getting a gift, Cherry. I have decided I'm not gonna. Oh my god. Then you know who I want? Oh my god. Life is hard. Life is hard. Where is that guy? Who is he saying that to? Yeah, he's complaining and he might just disappear right here, Bruce. No, he's sticking around. Wolf got one too. Okay. I would like you to call Tyler. Maybe get her with Tyler. Let's get them to become friends. Chat with him a couple times. Forget Paulette. We're going to get her with Cherry now. I know. I changed my mind like... Ha ha! Peach Bloom received an Amphiclops plush doll. Okay. I don't know why that's a red... Michael Donovan received a no snooze alarm clock. Boring. Cool. I'm glad you guys enjoyed the party. Sorry, you can't go anywhere until I decide. No, Paulette, no. You and Cherry. Where did she go? Did she leave? How did he get another one? Holy shit. Well, we're going to sell these, that's for sure. How did... What? Yeah, I have... And how is Rowan out... Is Rowan? How is he outside? There's got to be some sort of mod. Oh, good. There's got to be some sort of mod you can get. How about we call Paulette? There we go. Chat. Rowan's making a snow angel. A snow angel. Life is so beautiful. I watch the snow falling. The beautiful snow. My life has meaning. Let's watch the snow fall for a minute. Peaceful. That's awesome. Okay. I think it's time to go, but I had fun, so thanks. Look at all this shit. Holy moly moly. Holy roly poly moly. Okay, good. A few people haven't been able to leave, and that makes me happy. Yes, talk with Layla, because I would like her to be the next one. Ask about age, because let's be as rude as possible. How old are you? Because, by the way, you're really old. Ask if Sangle. Chiat. Just want to get to know her and spam. Oh. Do some funny stuff here. Make her laugh a little bit. Aw, Clementine and Wolf are talking. 48 days. Random red message that has no words. Let's compliment personality. Cedar, just F this gift-giving thing. We've already done some of this shit. Heat in the moment kiss. We should be able to get them together. Like, actually in a relationship or get her to move in or... something.
a lot.
That is what I would like. I would like that very much. Thank you. Dip kiss. Oh, she is his girlfriend. They are together. And he can't ask her to get married until she's older. So that's good to know that they are girlfriend and boyfriend. Right. It was Jake. And where is Jake? Did Jake come? Oh, there he is. Okay, so Rowan, come to the bathroom. Oh, I guess unclog it. Come to the bathroom. And then what you need to do is be romantic with your love, with your lover. And is Jake a teenager still, or is he an adult, or young adult, I mean? Because if he's a young adult, then we can get him to move in, hopefully. That would make me incredibly happy. So, Allo, you're still talking with Layla Al-Fahad. Flirt. Try to get to know her as much as possible. We gotta... If we can become friends, then the next time she comes over, we can become more than friends. Hey, I'll take a modest success. I will take a modest success any day of the frackin' week. Any day, my friends. High five! What's happening, man? High five. Keep it roll. Consider attractiveness. But I think she's cute. Get to know. Okay. Jake is a teenager. No. Oh, she's a snob. Awesome. Yeah, just come on over, Willow, and just drink all our drinks. That's fucking fabulous. Who did this painting? I'm curious. It was him. Okay, good to know. Good to know. Good to know. Good to know. No, I was debating for a second. Do I age up Carlotta and get it? Oh, I can. I can ask her to marry, even though she's a teenager and like, Rowan's only like... I mean, sorry, Cedar's only like 19, and she's like 17, so, you know. Yes, 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 you love each other. Yes, 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 you love each other. Yeah. I'm anti-marriage in real life. I think it's ridiculous, but... Oh, what a weird hug. But they are so adorable together, and they are now engaged. They can get married at a wedding party. Let's just get married right now. Right here in front of everyone. Let's do it. Nothing. Well, it is special because they love each other. That's all that matters. It's the politics around marriage that I think are just retarded. Like, you don't need a piece of paper or to finance blood diamonds to say you love somebody. It's just really stupid. Like, my partner, I've been with my partner for over 7 years, and we completely committed and we're crazy about each other, and that's, just kiss her forehead. And that's not going to change, but we're totally against marriage. We're not going to do that. So is she moved in now? No, the game did not automatically move her in, so we are going to have to do that ourselves. So let's do that. Enros, master controller. Add sim. Let's see. Where's name? Duh. Alphabetical order, Holly. Okay, so it's Carlotta Shu, right? Yay, she's added to the house! That is awesome! Okay, go about your business then. See, actually, how much time do we have until she ages up? One day. We could get pregnant. Let's do it. Let's do it now. Let's go have a woohoo, you and me. Oh, he can't. Okay, all right, that's fine. We will wait the one day for her to age up. I am not upset about that, realistically. But yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, I think marriage is a complete and total sham. So yeah, especially considering how many people think, oh, we're making a commitment, and they get married, and they go through all the bullshit, and they spend thousands of dollars on a wedding, and it's such a frickin' waste, you know, and then they get divorced, or they cheat on each other, and it's like, You guys are idiots. Like, you just spent how much money on a wedding, how much money on a dress and a tux and fucking wedding rings and flying your aunt in from Japan or some bullshit, and, you know, or when people go elsewhere to get married, that's another stupid thing. Oh my God, I got nothing good to say about marriage, the institution that is marriage, and pretty well anything in the status quo I have nothing good to say about, because it's all crap, and we should question absolutely everything, because it all has horrific ritualized roots that date back thousands and thousands of years, so I recommend looking into that. Aloe, you need to eat something, baby. Eat some tri-tip tofu steak. And then, are we friends yet with, what's-her-face? Layla? We are still... Oh, she's a Pisces, like me. We are still just acquaintances. Consider attractive. Danny, she wants to know if Rowan Bloom... No. No, no. No whatsoever. There's Jake, but where is Rowan? Whoa. Ah, we're getting the message that Willow's showing. That's wonderful. Can you not get in the house, buddy? You can get in the house. I didn't lock... Yes, I did lock this door. Can you get in the house? Let's see if you can get in the house. Come on, Rowan. No, you cannot, because I did lock the doors. So, I'm going to teleport you. And then we got to... You should... awesome. Oh yeah, and she just started her job too. I don't think I'm... What? How come I can't talk with... There we go. Wait. I am confused. Okay, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Let's ask him to marry... Or... Is he still a teenager? Yeah, we can't try for baby because he's still a teenager. But I bet if we spam some stuff, we'd be able to ask him to get married or something like that. Compliment personality. Let's just do a bunch of spammy stuff. I'm gonna unlock the door in a minute. That way people can leave if they really want to. It's weird. Rowan looks so much older than him now. It's kind of weird. It's kind of pedophilic. Pedophilic. Aloe? I want... Oh, you're going to throw up soon. You're just going to throw up outside. I see that happening. Can't get to a toilet. I'm not laughing at her misfortune of throwing up. I think throwing up is one of the worst things in the world. The worst things in the world. Oh, my God. Who said that? Who said that? Was that... That was Nicholas Riverhawk, wasn't it? With Peach? Did I read that right? Let's go find out. Let's friendly introduce him. Unless he was saying it about Clementine, which... Oh, it's possible. He could have been saying it about either one. It was Nicholas, wasn't it? Come on, Peach. Maybe we should get with Nicholas Riverhawk. He's a good-looking guy. He makes some cute little babies. Let's romantic consider... Oh, I can't consider attractiveness, eh? But I can spam some of... No, 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 no. That was a mistake on my part. But we can spam some romantic and friendly things to get to know. Catch anything? ask if single, ask about alma mater, ask sign. I'm going to try my hardest to make sure this episode isn't 2 hours. And I have nothing but respect and nothing but appreciation for those of you who have actually watched through my entire episodes, you know, even if they're crazy, crazy long. Romantic interest. I'd say he's more than a romantic interest. Propose going steady. Finally! Finally! Snow, what's wrong with you? Go up to bed, darling. Go up to bed. Set bed ownership. I'm going to double check that this is under snow. Go to bed. Uh-oh. Oh, mama. That was awesome. Did you ask him out? What happened? No, no, no. You can't leave. You can't leave, Jake. Not until we've solidified that we are together forever. Are they? Just do an interaction, please. I want to see what it says. And then you can eat. Then you can eat. I promise. I promise. Boyfriend! 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 That's wonderful. Okay, eat the grilled salmon. And then have a shower. And then we're going to go upstairs to our new bed. Set bed ownership. I just want to make sure. I'm pretty sure I set all of these. I just want to make sure. Aw, did you see that? That was sweet. You can't see it now, but Cedar. This is Cedar, right? Cedar was dreaming about Carlotta. That's really sweet. I love that. They're married now. They're married now. Is it time to give Carlotta a, what are you doing? Why are you sleeping in there? Sleep with your husband. I know you're young, but... Oh, great. Great. By a table tennis table? That's just funny to me. Table tennis table? From being a teenager. There's just something funny about that. So that means that Jake probably disappeared. Which is fine. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to unlock the door. Whoopsie. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Yep. Yep, we get it. She's pregnant. We understand. We know the deal by now. We know the deal by now. Oh, wow! Layla's a witch, too. They're friends. Oh, that's so sweet. Let's see if we can become more than friends. Peach is so adorable. Oh my god. So cute. I love her. Oh. Mm-hmm. Nagi Bush Kanye. That's all I have to say about that. Have you still not eaten, dude? You gotta eat. Please. Please eat. Oh. Peach made a move. And he made one back. Oh, that makes me so happy. Can we go steady? This is interesting that I'm pairing up these kids with so many different people, you know, that, well, their mom was interested at one point. Is he going to leave? You're going to leave now, aren't you, Nicholas? You got what you wanted, and now you're leaving. Han Chang. A one, a two, a Chang, 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 four. Community is awesome. Both the show and the idea. Okay, and then your bed. Peach, you love turquoise, don't you? This is your bed. That's right. Oh, the party died out. Actually, it died out quite late, didn't it? That's awesome. Okay, we're gonna... Willow, you can get up, and we're gonna get... Ian is just locked in this house now. I think that's hilarious. Oh my god. Okay, well, we're gonna move in Ian. Because, duh. Add sim. Name. Ian. Nolly. He is added to the who? Oh my god! Well, we don't got a mother load anymore. That's for fucking sure. Let's see here. Hello? Oh, he's a mermaid. Shit. I know nothing about mermaids, like in the game. I know nothing. I've never played a mermaid. Let's see. You have a relationship. Are you a vehicle enthusiast? No. He's flirty, couch potato, great kisser, schmoozer, mooch, and he loves indie music. Kelp as a food and orange. He's a Gemini. This is your girlfriend. This is your old friend. This is your boss. What job do you have? You're a rookie. Okay. You can keep that job, sure. How do I do this? Fish is good, but kelp is better. I don't know what he eats. I'm going to have to look this up. Hydration. Mermaid skin dries out easily and requires constant hydration to stay soft and supple. Frequent baths, showers, and dips in the pool or ocean are a must. Okay, these are all the same. Okay, so we're going to change your bathroom then if that's the case, because we're going to have to give you a shower tub combo. So I got a little proactive and I read a few things online about mermaids. We're going to have to put a pool in because he needs to swim like once every 48 hours. So I wonder, I didn't see anything about hot tubs, unfortunately. So I'm kind of wondering, maybe if I have a hot tub, maybe that will be okay, you know, but I don't know. We'll have to see. Is Willow just able to go into the other house? Look at all these freaking snow angels. And apparently he will only get like 25% satisfaction from normal, like human, food, as opposed to fish or kelp. So I'm just shifting around trying to get comfy course. So I'm wondering, I mean, there's a lake right near our house, so maybe we don't have to put a pool in. Maybe not. Maybe what we should do instead is go for a little swim. Go for a swim, buddy. Let's follow him to the ocean. Oh, yeah, you can't get out? Wait a second. But I specified Sims for this door, which means that you should be able to get out. Let me see. Unlock this. Lock. Specify Sims for this door. Oh, right. He wasn't moved in when we did that. So there we go. There we go. Go swimming. There we go. Awesome. That makes me happy. Let's check on everybody, shall we? Aloe's sleeping in an igloo and she wants to throw a party for Sky. When is it Sky's birthday? When is it his birthday? 2 days. Okay. Michael, how you going? Wait, I'll go back to Aloe for a second. She wants to become best friends with Sky. Aw. Yeah, F the party. Let's just become best friends. Did we just become best friends? Michael, you are not meant to be in this bed. This is Rowan's bed. Yes. Wake up, because you're being a maggot. Oh, let's go check out Ian. There's his tail! I've never played with a mermaid before! Polar Bear Club! Swimming in icy waters has earned Ian an honorary membership to the Polar Bear Club. Members have shown a strong immunity to the cold. That is wonderful. Michael, you gotta, yeah, get it. I'm hilarious. This bed is Rowan's bed. So, frig off. It seems like the beds have, like, reset themselves or something. It's really weird. Sleep here. It's Carlotta's birthday. Sleep here. And it shouldn't be. She's supposed to be on maternity leave for 3 days. Oh, well. If she does go to work, that's fine. Set bed ownership to Aloe. Yes, he will. He can sleep there. Who's in bed? It's Sky. Well, he's got to get up anyway. Eat leftovers, grilled salmon. How's Peach? Oh, Peach is exhausted. Our poor girl. This whole jock, nerd, rebel shit. I'm sorry. People cannot be lumped into three teeny tiny specific groups. You know? I have my jock moments where we go on long, hours-long hikes and up very steep mountains and things around here, and I'm an obvious nerd. I think that that's really obvious. And then also, I'm very much a rebel because I'm anti-system. So I don't know. I don't need to lock this. Okay, it's unlocked for everybody. That's wonderful. That's the way I want it to be. I want the main house to be available for everybody, but the little individual houses will be just for those specific people. What's going on with Cherry? Cherry is hungry. There's who yelled that? Was it that was Snow? Let's go. There's that Pink Floyd thing again. You should go listen to that album if you've never listened to The Wall, or Animals, or Dark Side of the Moon, or my personal favorite, Wish You Were Here. That's a great album. They're all great albums, but that's my favorite of theirs. The Division Bell's fucking awesome too, so do your homework, kiddies. Listen to Pink Floyd before episode 9, and we'll talk about it. There'll be a quiz on it later. Yeah, you don't need to sleep until fully rested. F all that S. Just unclog this and go to the bathroom and clean this and whoopsies and go to the bathroom and then sleep in your own bed. Actually eat something. Clean out the bad food first. Has everybody gone? That's really great. It is really, really great after a big party when the house is just filled with all these people. It is so nice to have a break when all the kids go to school. That is such a nice little break. Let's get on. Let's become friends, because we are not. No. Why did I... I'm just so used to spamming romantic. I just didn't even think about it for a second. That was kind of funny. Chets. Ask if he slept well. Michael is such a ginky voice. It's not terrible. It's just really, really funny when you hear it. I haven't really listened to it. Awesome. Cherry didn't go to school. That's fine by me. Watch the cooking channel. Yeah, Cherry's going to be our little chef. That is going to be her lifetime whatever. Make some waffles, and then what we will do is we are going to watch TV. And then while she's doing that, Clementine didn't go to school either. Again, fine with that. Have some grilled salmon, and then use the bathroom and have a shower. Peach is in bed. I keep looking for them over here, but I forget that they're actually upstairs sleeping. So we just have the two kids upstairs sleeping. Carlotta, where are you going? Good. Yeah, you can't get in there. I don't want you to get in there. What is this? Throw eggs at a Sim's house? I've never seen that. Oh my God. Can I throw an egg at your house? No, I can't throw an egg at your house. Respond to question. What is his question? Ask about day. Aw, that's sweet. That's a sweet thing. I like it. Like it. It's good. Learn charisma. Why not? She's leaving. You should go eat something, man. I wish different fridges, though. Like, that bugs me, because now that I have separate house, it's like I don't want everything that's in Aloe's fridge to be in my fridge. I want us to have our separate little fridges, you know? That makes sense to me. A lot of kids didn't go to school today. Awesome. Fight the machine. Okay. She just got married. I love that. That's so cute. We've heard great things about you. There's only one place, apparently, 19 Alpine Drive, for people to... Who is this? Who are you? Aloe should get to know you, I think. Who are you? Where are you? Show up. Show up, please. There he is. He is... Kelsey Ramos. No. Wait where you are. Let's friendly introduce and hopefully he'll stay in place. No. Come back here. That is a creepy toad. Look at the eyes on that. Freaky. Freaky Friday. Ooh, more people. Andrew Song. That's beautiful. And Jewel Song. Oh, they're together and they're flirting with each other in public. That's so sweet. Let's eavesdrop on these people. Are you cold? What's going on? Are you going to build a... Do you want to build an igloo? Come on, teleport here and meet... What's his face? Kelsey Ramos. There she is. Lar Shibi. Come on over. Get to know him. I'd like to be with Layla next time, but it's good to meet some more people. Oh, and they got some good stuff. She didn't get that with Layla, if I remember correctly. Absolutely. Yes. Okay, well, we know this guy now. So, no, you were not meant to be. That is unacceptable. His arms looked really funny there for a second. Like, what the hell's going on? What's going on? She's... Well, hey, we haven't looked at Carlotta's stuff, I don't think. Loves the outdoors, vehicle enthusiast, athletic, mean-spirited. Oh, boy. She's talking about sharks. Fight? No. Why do you want to fight with everybody? I mean, I know you're mean-spirited, but... Come on. Oh. This episode will definitely be done when we have the babies. The multiple babies. Complain about laziness. Hey, they'll definitely have that in common. Not be interested in laziness. Carlotta's going to age up, so that means we're going to be able to give her a makeover, 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 makeover. Who is this? This guy is cute. Absolutely. And he's got funky eyes, so that, I don't know, that makes me think.
Helly horny. I'm really horny right now. Want to meet at my place?
Oh my god, that billboard. Oh my god. So, she went on a date with somebody else. She wants to flirt with Kelsey. Oh, come on. The weight of responsibility is heavy on your shoulders. It's time to pull yourself away from checking for wrinkles in the mirror and do something about it. Your youth is out there. You just have to keep living it, right? Then why do you feel like you're right on the edge of a nervous breakdown? That should have been a question mark, EA. Should have been a question mark. I'm liking this guy. Who is this guy? Ryan Anderson. Hello, Ryan. Let's get in good with you. I love the sound of the snow. It's so beautiful. In the game or real life, it is so beautiful. He has a good sense of humor. That means we are going to become friends very fast. Very, very fast. Good sense of humor, good foot round. Good sense of humor, impersonate celebrity. Oh my god, did you hear that? That was my stomach. Did you hear it over the snow? Corsican Bistro. Of course you can. Ah, go to the Corsican. I am so clever, it's ridiculous. Bow down to my cleverness. Who's hunting you? Where is there a vampire? Who's this? Who's this? Come here. Scott Chesterfield. Oh, is he related to Brucey? Juicy Brucey? Yes, I don't care. I could not care less. I am going to friendly introduction, and I am going to Anna Menon friendly introduction so that I get some more people on this list. We got to get some ladies up in this piece. Oh, here's another one. Jessica Willow. That'd be weird. My daughter's name is Willow. Let's fuck. What is a Diaz? What is a Diaz? Issue trivia challenge. Okay, well... What? What? Tell me he disappeared and he didn't just vampirically die. Scott is talking with Aloe. Who is this? Simon. Well, hello, my name is Simon, and I like to do drawings. You guys remember that show from the 80s? That was a show I used to watch as a little girl. I was born in 81, so, yeah. All the things of that time, gummy bears and the early Sesame Street before they started propagandizing. Who is this? Maya Abbott. Your hat is ridiculous. Who is this? That's Dainey. I don't want to go after Dainey's shoe. We already have a shoe in the family. Yeah, we got to meet as many people as possible. She was meant to be on a date, which I think is really, really funny. But she just totally abandoned. What is this? Hilarious conversation. Some shims should be stand-up comedians with the humor they're dishing out. Oh my god, I've never seen that. Like, okay, I've been playing this game since... When did Sims 3 come out? And I am still... Nope, she's a shoe. Shoe. And I am still floored sometimes by some of the things that show up. And talk with Maya for a few minutes. You're starting to get cold, however, so we're going to have to go home soon. Announce pregnancy. Guess what? I'm as big as a house because of baby reasons. And then friendly introduce her, and then Gabriela Ornales, friendly introduce to her. Try to get to know as many people as possible. Aloe learned that Maya is excitable. Aloe's starting to feel, well, yeah, understandable. Who's this? Did I talk to you? Franziska Vanderberg. Oh! How are you related? How are you related to, Renald? Huh. I don't know. Okay, so she's met all these people. Let's go home now. I guess teens will be teens. Not for long, because she's gonna age up in like 10 minutes. She wants to be, super popular. Okay, let's do it. Let's make that her lifetime wish. Why not? It'll be extra funny because she's mean-spirited. So, and I'm not really going to push her lifetime want for her. It's just going to be funny how it works out. And Clementine, who do I want you to be with again? La 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 la. Who was it that I thought you should be with? I think Clementine was up in the air now because we don't have Tyler anymore. So let's try with Benjamin Larson, because we were going to try with Benjamin Larson when it came to Willow, but it just did not work out that way, which is fine. I'm really happy about how things worked out. But let's talk to this guy, and then... Because you're doing pretty great, actually. You're doing quite happy. Quite happily you are. Cedar and Carlotta. Okay, Aloe, yes, come home. Come home, love. Oh, good, she's home. Go to sleep for a while. Go to sleep. I do like that there are more Sims in the house than I can actually focus on other Sims. Why? Why? What is going on? What is going on in my house? What's going on in my family? I don't know why these guys are not getting on. Because he was late? What is this? I just saw Acrobat gig. Audition for, you already have a gig scheduled at this proprietor's venue. So if that's the case, set up the stage. Use the venue setup. Why not? Why not? Why not? I've never done this before, so this will be interesting. I think at a certain point I would like to have one of the heirs or heiresses be like a famous singer or something like that. Okay. Can I not do anything then? Do I have to go back to the... I have to go back to the... audition for the Acrobat gig. What are you doing here? So this is going to be your audition. This will be your audition. Just standing right here and doing stuff. Holy moly! Michael can bend! He is bendy! Bendy! That is cool. Wow, you're awesome! On Tuesday? Okay, we'll give it another shot then. In the meantime, go home. Willow? Himmelder. How are you? How goes things? Stir crazy, we're gonna get rid of that because I think stir crazy is a really stupid. Some of the moodlets are really stupid, I think. I'm a hermit, stay at home sort of person. Like, I can go out, I'm totally fun, but at the same time, I like to be alone. I like to be at home. I like to be in my studio. I like to be in my bedroom playing video games and stuff. You know, like, I'm not a big leave the house person, especially if it's chilly, even though I love cold weather. It's like, nah. I think I'm just gonna stay in and wear 4 sweaters and 3 pairs of socks and just get really comfy cozy. Cedar, what is going on with you? He is fascinated from contemplating an interesting object. Yeah, why not do some mopping? We have a lot of money now, though, so that's making me think about possibly getting a maid. I have been dabbling in thoughts of that, but it hasn't been something... Who's sleeping with who? Snow is sleeping with her mom, I bet. Yep, that's really cute. That's really cute. Rowan, you're gonna work out? Okay, that's fine. We'll deal with that. Ian, where is Ian? Is he at home? Oh, Carlotta's birthday! Exciting. That means we're gonna be able to give her a makeover. That's gonna be really wonderful. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna change those wretchedly teeny tiny little beady eyes of hers. She's beautiful in her own way. Holy hell, loudness. All right, age up now. Enough of the song and dance. Age up. There we go. Rock music. Yeah, rocking out. You won't be allowed to choose one. She got heavy sleeper. That is a terrible trait. What a stupid trait. Terrible trait. All right. We'll just deal with it. What? Oh, God, I thought Sky was aging up, too. She wants to go to France. I want to let them go to France. Huh. Maybe that's where they could get impregnated. That would be really great, wouldn't it? Have a little French baby, and we could name it Croissant. And here is Carlotta. Unfortunately, her hair sticks out of her hood, but we're just going to ignore that. She's actually cuter than... I thought she was. She's got that weird little double chin or whatever. But she's cuter than I thought. Much cuter. So, this is her outerwear. Here is her adorable and très, très comfy sleepwear. Her favorite color is yellow, so everything's going to be yellows and browns and blacks and whites. Here is her simple yet a little strange formal outfit. Her accent is blue. I'm making all of her accents blue so that she stands out a little bit in a certain way. Because Willow's accents are... Willow's accent is red. So it's nice to have something a little bit different. And then last, but certainly not least, is her everyday wear. I want her to be a bit more of a posh sim, even though she's not a snob or anything else like that. But she's a little mean-spirited, and to me, that's kind of snobby. So, yeah, I want her to be a little more posh. I am loving this family more and more and more and more. See, it's nice, eh? From far away, you can see the blue leather. Well, it'd be pleather in this case, because there's no animal. Let's just say in the Simverse, there is an animal that will give you blue leather. And we are going to put a table in here. Let's do that right now. So as you can see, I've changed a few things here. I turned the little playpen. I also fixed it because I noticed that it had fabric on the outside here where the yellow is. I gave us a beautiful table. I love this table. I don't even know where it came from. It's a custom something and I've never seen it before today. It's really weird. It's like things choose to show up in my bi mode sometimes, and then other times they don't. It's the weirdest thing. And then I got rid of one of the cribs, and I bought another pote just to have it. I think that'd be best. Doodad. Yes, what's going on with you? What is going on with you, Carlotta? Well, you need to go to the bathroom and go to bed, like I already said. And then let's see how things are going in the other house. What's happening here? Yep, get up, Willow. Get on up, girly. Get on up. Get on up. So this episode will be done actually quite soon, because I can see how large she is. As soon as Willow and Aloe have their respective babies, that will be the end of episode 8. I want to try to keep it under an hour, but we all know that's probably not going to fucking happen. So, but the point is, I'm making an effort. I am making an effort to have that happen. So what I've decided is that any children that are born not by the heir/heiress or the founder, Aloe, it's only going to be one founder, obviously. Any children who are not born are not going to count towards that 100 babies and the 100 baby challenge. That it is only the founder and any heirs and heiresses that have children that will count towards that number. But it'll just be interesting to say, oh, well, so far we have had, well, in this case, right? So far we've had 9 babies towards the challenge. Oh, bless you, Willow. Let's say in a few more babies, we can say, oh, we've had 12 babies toward the challenge, because maybe that's what Aloe will have, is 12 babies or something. And then altogether, by the time she reaches elder, and then Willow has 3, and we'll just say, oh, that's 15 altogether. But the 15 is not the number we're going by. It's the 12, because, yeah, I've explained this. You guys aren't stupid. I think you get it. I hope you're not stupid. I think you get it. Flaky, ew, bits of skin are flaking off. Maybe some water would help. And he's also hungry. So what's this? Feed regularly. That's a creepy way to say it, really. Okay, you need to go swimming. And then I would like you to fish. He needs to swim and fish, like, often. How's Cherry going? Cherry's in bed. Clementine's in bed. Rowan's just standing there staring at his sisters. Creepy. You're freaking me out, Rowan. You're freaking me out. Okay, go take a shower and use the bathroom and then go downstairs and get something to eat. Have a hamburger and then go back to bed. Actually, no. I was thinking maybe I'll get him a job, but I don't want to get him a job because I want him ultimately to be a stay-at-home dada. Yeah, get the hell out, man. Get out. Get out forever. I think that would be the best. Yes, have a shower. Stop complaining. God dang nabbit. For cock's sake. Okay. Eat a hamburger. And then we'll see where we're at that point. Aloe's getting quite large. Have some grilled salmon, honey bunny. That's so funny. Are they wearing the same? They're not wearing the same, are they? That'd be funny if they were. She's wearing that lacy black thing. No, Willow's is different, but it was... Is it different? Yeah, it's different, but it was still funny. Okay, Willow. My one daughter, Louise, is scuffling around trying to... I think she's after a fly or something. What do I want you to do, Willow? What do you need for your job? Mood and gardening. Well, we can't do any gardening right now, unfortunately. But also we can. Ooh, Holly has an idea. As you can see, I've put 5 little plants in here. I've given her a bumble leaf, ginseng, chamomile, sweetgrass, and buzzberry. Just stuff that, like little herb things you can grow inside your house. I think that's wonderful. So now she can garden at home, which I think is fabulous. Let's harvest some of this. Come on home, Willow. Come on home and harvest this. It's going to be exciting to see when we finally get more and more houses and more houses on this lot. I mean, there are only so many houses I can put on this lot, obviously. But it's going to be exciting because it'll be more like a little compound for everybody. Oh my God, they're so close to giving birth. They're really close to giving birth. I'm very excited. I already have some names picked out, but I'm not going to say it yet. We'll see how things go. Where did she go? Oh, I had to plant some out here for some reason. It wouldn't let me erase. It's graduation day. Carlotta is graduating. Cool. I don't care about that. We've already seen a crappy little graduation. I don't care. Seriously? But she's pregnant. I am confused. Why would she be going to work? She's supposed to be having the next 3 days off or whatever. Okay, do whatever you want now, Willow. But I'm glad I made you do that because you needed to do that. You should go to the bathroom. Don't sit at the computer. We all do that way too much. Me included. Go to the bathroom. Have a shower. Fix that. No, Cherry, come on. And Cherry, you need to go to the bathroom. And then I'd like you to come here and serve more breakfast because you need to learn more. Where is Ian? Ian should be in the ocean, huh? No, he's at home. You need to go to the ocean, bud. You need to go swim right now. You don't need to sleep. Go swim. Go swimming. Come on. Get going. I just realized I never gave Ian an actual makeover like I did with, Carlotta. I probably will. I just don't want to right this second. There's his tail. Snow skips school on a field trip day. Nobody cares. I don't care. Definitely not me. I don't care. Where are you going? No, don't go home. Why are you going home? That's stupid. That's stupid. Can he eat just, what you call it, fish? Yeah, he's hungry. That's his problem. We're going to fish. Once you get out, we're going to fish. There we go. Fish a little bit. Whatever fish you catch. No! No! No, no! Oh my God, Cherry! Cherry! What are you doing, girl? What are you doing? Who's going to extinguish? I can't do anything. I don't want to do anything here. I don't want to micromanage this. I know this is the situation where someone could die. And I just want Peach to get the hell out of the way because I'd be the most sad if she went. Somebody extinguish it, please. Because I don't buy fire alarms or whatever. I always forget. You guys are just going to go outside, hey? Okay, you can't just go outside. No, no, no. Aloe, it's going to have to be you. Meet up. It's going to have to be you. No one else is taking the initiative. No one else is even bothering. Go extinguish the flames. Whoa, my God. Be a brave little mama. Oh, my God. We're just going to have to replace all this shit. Cherry, bad girl. I mean, you're trying with your cooking and stuff, but... Oh, my God. My poor family. Insurance is granting you 204 simoleons to cover your loss from the fire. Yeah, thanks a fucking lot. 140. 400. 140. So we're up to like, what was that? 680? And insurance gave me like $200. What is this? Waiting for graduates. Oh, we're all going off to graduation. That's what's going on. That's why nobody would extinguish it. I wonder if it wasn't graduation, if everybody would actually have... Or a couple Sims, anyway. I know one of the Sims is brave. Who is it? Is it Sky? Yeah. Kids can't extinguish fires, can they? Just too bad, because I think that would have been cool. A formal dance is... Oh, random horses. Ian, how you doing, buddy? Whoa, what is this? It's too hot. Excessive warmth makes mermaid skin brittle. Yeah, you get to go home. You need to go home. You need to. We'll follow Aloe for a few minutes, and then we'll see how it goes.
Veronica Gonzalez.
Where's the applause? There should be applause. Chapped. What do you have in your inventory, Ian? You didn't get any fish, eh? That's funny. The graduation, just hearing the voices. Jerry all come British. All right, I want you to... You need to learn that it's important to fish. Go fish. All right. Do we have any fish? No, just eat a little steak and then we're going to go fish. Actually, eat a little steak and then we will take a bath. But I need to, it's good that they live right near the ocean. That's really, really good. Oh, he's so old. I really love Simon. Well, hello, my name is Simon, and I like to do drawings. Oh, Carlotta has graduated from community high school with honor. Most likely to become a sports star. Say what? Near. Not likely, more like. But she's old enough now, so I want to get her pregnant. I'm just going to get everybody pregnant. The house is just going to be filled with fucking kids. Meet a vampire. Let's see. Oh my god. Everybody go home. This graduation thing pisses me off because I don't want them all to leave the house all the time. It's just too much managing. Earn an A in school? I guess we could try. Now he, Wolf, he wants to learn mixology, so I'm kind of like, let's get him at the bar and let's get him mixing. Let's get him mixing shit. Where's Ian? Ian is home. Okay, he's eating, so that's good. He ate something. He's feeling a little bit better. Waiting for things to load, waiting for things to load. Yes. Oh my god. Mermaids suck, man. As they eat, and immediately their hunger is going down, it does like fuck all. That sucks. Go do that. We gotta get you fishing. Fishing's gotta be your thing. You got to fish. I'm actually just gonna... No. That's out of the question. She's with someone. I'm just gonna... You know what? F all this S. I'm just gonna bulk you up. Again, we know I don't do this very, very often. I only do it in extreme situations. Just go fish. Like that game. Okay. The house is a mess. It's a mess. Yeah, you eat something, Carlotta. Yes, Cherry. Yes, Cherry. Yes, Cherry. Yes. Forensic specialist, dynamic DNA profiler? Not quite. That's not up to Cherry's speed. I love that we put this table here. Oh, it makes my life so much better. Okay, you're done eating, so you go to the bathroom, Wolf, and then I want you to come outside and practice making drinks. Where's Cedar at? Where you at, Cedar? Sell this. Join law enforcement career? I don't fucking think so. You aren't a corrupt individual. You're a good person. Continue writing free verses not to free. Who's this? That's Willow. Having herself a little rack attack. Is no one going to sit in these chairs? Does that mean I have to pull the table out a little bit? That's crap, though. What happened with him? Set up the stage. Oh, okay, good. Yeah, Aloe, you can go. Go visit Simon. I almost want to... Nah. I just want to... Cheat all over the place just to make things the way I want to make them. Which I don't think is a terrible thing, really. I kind of want her to get with Simon Cho. Whoa. Okay. The game's taking me to him for some frickin' reason. Just venue is fine. In the snow, even. Give it up for me, Dane Belly Up. I don't understand this Dane Belly Up thing. Why did he name himself that? That's so weird. Oh. Hello, then. Oh, they still flirt like crazy with each other. That's so cute. I almost want to ask him to, like, get married or something, but I'll take a romantic photo because, yeah. She looks really great pregnant, eh? You know, just some women look really great pregnant and other women just kind of look fat and angry. Not every pregnancy is beautiful. I mean, in theory it is, but you know what I mean. Aw, I almost want to have more kids with Simon before he... kiss goodbye. Oh my god, after what I just said, that's really disturbing. Before he kicks it. Nah, I mean, let's go check out everybody. Let's flip through everyone here. Why is Ian taking personal time off? Because he went to graduation instead of going to work? Is that what's going on? Oh, Willow's, Willow's, Willow, 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 Willow. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Come on. You can do it, honey. I know it's your first one. I know it's your first one. Actually, that's funny. Yeah. I'll say it in a second. Marry Ian. Yes, we are going to do that. We are definitely going to do that. All right, Willow. Hopefully it's a girl. Hopefully it's a girl, because that would tie into what I'm thinking. Actually, I have two names in mind, so I really, really hope... I would love twins. I would love twins, a boy and a girl. I would love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Love everything about it. This is not going to make a difference whatsoever, but I am going to give you the fertility treatment right now. But that's not going to do anything. Although, wouldn't it be funny if it did? Your sim show isn't going too well. Try mixing it up with more variety to really wow the audience. I think Michael needs to do something else with his life. I don't think this whole... Yes. Good job, Ian. Good job. Ugh, I just gotta chill. I'm feeling her pain. The reviews of your show are in. I've seen good juggling, good miming, and good contortion. None of which were in this performance. Aww, that makes me sad in my tummy. Good job, Wolf. I love that we're getting them started onto what they'd like to do, you know, and then maybe... they'll do things a little more autonomously on their own. A boy! Okay. Juniper. Juniper. Loves the cold and is friendly. Please give me more, 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 more. Ah, just one. I'm disappointed. I'm not totally disappointed. Not totally. But I know if she has a daughter, what I'm going to name it. Oh, there's that creepy face that doesn't quite, isn't quite a face. Okay, give your son some lovin's. No, 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 no. Don't you dare. Don't you fraggin' dare. Snuggle and put Juniper in crib. Juniper Bloom. Oh, he's so cute. He's so cute. He's so beautiful. Shower. Go to sleep. And then let's jump over to Aloe again because she's going to be giving birth soon. What is this? Coffee breath. Oh, yes. They just stand there making noises at each other. Oh my god. Ask to break up with Alicia. Oh boy. No, we're not going to do that. Unfortunately, as is... Why are you so angry? Because it didn't do so well. What is this? Flamed out. Michael totally bombed the show. Can we apologize? Apologize. We did the best we could, Kelsey. Come on. Don't be mean about it. Nah, just go home, buddy. I don't know why you've got that awful ass hair again. When I tell you something,
Do it.
So Willow got pregnant like maybe a sim hour before Aloe got pregnant. So I'm thinking that, yeah, let's do it. I'm thinking that Aloe should be given birth soon. What party? We just stood outside the city hall. That makes no sense to me at all. Can I move any of this stuff? Let's throw some of this shit out. Some of this horrifying quality shit. Oh, I can't anymore. It's got to be emptied. Oh, I see. Paulette, Rupin, and Cherry Bloom are no longer friends. Was it Paulette that I wanted Cherry to get with? I'm pretty sure it was, wasn't it? Oh, the rainar! It's raining! And here comes Aloe's baby! I don't know what I want to... Yes, I know exactly what I'm going to name these babies. If they're girls... Oh, I really hope it's they, and I really hope it's all girls. Because I have a theme that I'm going for, and it's just not going to work with boys. It's not going to work whatsoever. I mean, one of them could work. One of them could work. And I do have a possible idea when it comes to boys. I'll just have to think about it, I think. Yes, yes, just have the baby. Just have your baby. Have your baby. Please be a girl, please be a girl, please, 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 please. Girl, 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 girl. Boy, fuck. My disappointment is large. Okay. How about Basil? Basil Bloom, please give me more than one child. Basil is a genius and brave. Another brave child. More, more, more. Seriously? What is with all these single births? I don't understand. Like, I'm not disappointed that she's had babies. I mean, that's fine. That's wonderful. But single births, I just don't understand why this keeps happening. No, no, no. Oh, he disappeared for a second. That was weird. Give him some attention. So they both had sons. And I had this whole idea of what I wanted to name him. Oh, maybe I'll save it for next time, even though it won't be the right time of year. But yeah, I had some cool ideas with that. So that is episode 8. So many things have happened. Carlotta has moved in and aged up. Ian has moved in. Carlotta and... what are these? Oh, these are gems. Cool. They just look weird with the snow on them. Carlotta and... Oh, God. Cedar have gotten married. I'm really excited to see what will happen next. And we've had two little babies. Willow's had her little baby, Juniper Bloom. And Aloe's had little Basil Bloom. Even though I couldn't use the names I wanted to use, it's still really cute, Basil Bloom. Basil's actually my favorite herb. So I was like, yep, of all the things I'm going to name him, that works out the most. Look at all these flies. Can you still die by... flies in Sims 3? I don't know. Thank you all so very much for watching. I hope you're having a beautiful day filled with peace, unity, love, light, joy, creativity, and boundless energy and just fabulous wonderfulness. There's a plate stuck in the wall. Let's put it on the table so someone can clean it up. Next episode, we are going to get Aloe pregnant again and probably Willow and probably Carlotta and see if we can actually get... what's his face? Jake Preston to move on in with Rowan and see if they can get pregnant, if Rowan can actually get pregnant. I've never tried two males before, so we'll have to see how that works out. We may end up with a bodiless head for 3 sim days, but hey, what are you going to do? So I hope you're having a fabulous day. We will talk soon. I hope you enjoyed episode 8. Thank you so much. And I guess all that's left to say is... Bye-bye!